Here we continue with part two of the practice problems for comprehensive exam number two. And in part two, we're looking at a number of word problems that all have something quadratic going on with them. The first is a word problem that asks us to find the dimensions of a picture that has a certain frame around it. like the problems online and in the book, we have the picture here drawn for us. But we're told that the big square is, there's my equal sign, 21% larger than the small square. And so the area of the big square, so 21% more means that it's 1.21 times the small square. And so this is the basic relationship that's described. So now if I know the dimensions of the big square and the small square, I should be able to do this. And if I just follow the picture, the dimensions of the small square are obviously x by x. So the area of the small square is 1.21x squared. The big square has dimensions x plus 2 by x plus 2. Realize that you're adding a 1-inch frame on both sides, so the dimension's going to be 2 inches bigger in each direction. So the big square has area x plus 2 squared. And so the question is, what are the dimensions of the original picture? In other words, what's x? And so we're just trying to solve this equation. This is not anything about vertex or anything like that. We're just trying to solve an equation that happens to have an x squared in it. So if you do that, I mean, it will have decimals in it. You can use the quadratic formula if you want. It does factor. And if you do that, you'll see that the answer is, the dimension should be 20. So there should be a 20 by 20 original picture and a 22 by 22 inch frame. And you can check that that has the right relationship. So the point here is that in some of the word problems we did before that led to an equation, if the equation that it leads to ends up being quadratic, then we have to use our methods like factoring or the quadratic formula in order to solve that. So that's one possibility. The more common thing that we'll see in that we've seen in this section, this is section 4.4, is a question where the answer is to maximize or minimize something. So we look for that phrase, maximize or minimize something. And so we know that we need a function, and it's going to be in terms of x, because that's what they ask us to find. We need a function whose outputs are revenue. So when x items are produced and sold, what's the revenue? The reason I know that is because that's the thing that I'm trying to maximize. The property of a parabola that we know about, parabolas have a vertex, and a vertex is an extreme y-coordinate. And we know that the y-coordinate on a graph corresponds to the output of a function. So if I want the extreme y-coordinate to correspond to maximum revenue, I need to make sure I have a function whose outputs are measuring revenue. And so the relationship that we've used in the past is that revenue is price times number sold. We're told that that x represents the number sold, and we're told that in order to accomplish that rate of sales, then that's the price that you should set. The price should be $8 minus 1/50th of x. And that's the sort of thing that you see with a supply and demand curve. It's usually the other way around. As far as the relationship goes, usually setting the price determines the demand that your object will have. But the idea of supply and demand is that the price and the number you're going to sell are related to each other. So in this case, this is written the right way around. Price is written in terms of x at the top there. And of course, x is written in terms of x. So price times number sold will look like that. And so if I can find the coordinates of the vertex of the graph of this function, then the input will be x, number sold, and the output will be revenue. And if that's at the vertex, then that will be the highest revenue that you can ever find. Notice that if we did multiply this out, this does have the coefficient of x squared is negative. It's negative 1 over 50. And so this is a downward facing parabola. The revenue for the graph looks like that. And so the vertex of the parabola is going to give us the place where revenue is maximized. So you can do the x coordinate of the vertex either by multiplying this out into ax squared plus bx plus c form and using the formula that we have, or you could think a minute about the fact that in this factored form that we have written here, that the zeros of the function, in other words, the values of x that make the function zero, are x equals 0 and x equals 400. And so the vertex would have to occur halfway between 0 and 400, which means the vertex has to happen at an x-coordinate of 200. So you can do it either way. But either way, we'll come to a conclusion that the x-coordinate is 200. To get the output, I plug 200 in for x, and I get 8 minus 4 is 4, times 200 is 800. So the result is, make sure I read the question, it says find the number of objects that produced maximize my revenue. So 200 objects is the answer to that question. It doesn't actually ask me what the maximum revenue is. I can see that here. The maximum revenue is $800. That's the most revenue you could make in this model. It does ask what price should be charged to result in this number of objects. And so for that, I go back to this equation that relates price and the number I expect to sell and put 200 in there. And so I should be selling 200 objects at $4 each. If I do that, then I will maximize my revenue. In part three, it extends this problem. It says we want to try to maximize profit, and so I need to have a profit function, and so for that I need to know that profit is revenue minus cost. Revenue is given to me, that's 8 minus 1/50th x times x. Cost is given to me, you have to be very careful that it's the whole cost you're subtracting, so make sure you subtract 100 plus 6x in parentheses to make sure it really says what you mean. So that's revenue minus cost. And so it's the same question. I need the vertex of that parabola. And in this case, there's nothing about this form, that tells me what my zeros are. And so I don't have that clue. It's not written in vertex form. So my only good choice here is to multiply this out and write this in ax squared plus bx plus c form, and then use the formula for the x-coordinate of the vertex is minus b over 2a. If you do that, you'll get, 36. 36 is the x-coordinate, and the y-coordinate is whatever it is. So it's when you plug 36 in, so I'll just say p of 36. So it's what you get when you plug 36 into the profit function. Notice that I'm using p here for profit. I'm trying to make it look like a capital P, to distinguish it from price. Don't let the fact that there's two P's running around the problem, there's a price of each object and there's a profit that you make overall. They both start with a P, but they are not the same thing. So anyway, so the question of how many objects should be produced, I don't really need to know what the maximum profit is for this problem. I just need to know that it happens when we sell 36 objects. On the last problem, of these word problems, this is one that we did before. We have a pen that has a river on one side, and so we have to build a rectangular pen. And so if it's rectangular, that means that the parallel sides have the same length, and I'll call that x. I only have 150 meters of fencing, so whatever x is, I know that this other side is 150 minus 2x. In order to have the sum of these three sides be 150, right? So If I add up those three numbers, whatever X is, those three numbers will add up to 150. And so that's what my fence will look like, no matter what X is. So if X is just 1 meter, that would be a ridiculous fence, but you'd have 1 meter here, 1 meter here, and 148 meters across here. So anyway, so we want to find the largest possible area. So again, that means I want a function whose outputs are areas, and I'm hoping that it'll be a parabola. I guess if I'm looking for largest, I'm hoping it will be a downward-facing parabola, and then that way the vertex y-coordinate will tell me the maximum output of the function. So fortunately, area of rectangle is very easy. Area is just the product of the two dimensions, like that. And so this is a downward-facing parabola, you can tell, because if you were to multiply this out, you would get a negative 2x squared. So negative 2 is going to be the number in front of the x squared term. And so again, the graph of this is going to look like a downward-facing parabola. And so it's going to have a high point, and that vertex is the highest y-coordinate you'll ever see. So if I can find the coordinates of that vertex, I'll be able to answer the question. So the vertex, again, is halfway between the zeros of this function, or you can multiply it out and use the normal formulas. But the a of x here has a zero at zero, x is zero, makes this function zero, but also if x is 75, it makes this function zero. So I'm just looking at these two pieces. When x is zero, the whole thing is zero, and when x is 75, this part is zero, which makes the whole thing zero. So halfway between zero and 75 is 37.5. And then the area there is whatever it is. It's whatever you get by plugging 37.5 in for x. But again, the question is, what are the dimensions of the rectangle? And to know that, I just need to know what this x is. So the x is 37.5 meters. This is 37.5 meters. And that means this is 75 meters. So those are the values of the fence along the sides, how long the fence has to be along each side in order to have a rectangle that has as large of areas possible.